The first item of the business this afternoon is debate on the report on the freedom of religion and other human rights for non-Muslim minorities in Turkey.
The case of Mor Gabriel Monastery in Turkey. This is part of the Syriac Orthodox Church. It's clearly a very ancient, this is a very ancient church, one of the most ancient branches of Christianity, and this is a truly ancient monastery.
Unfortunately, the Mor Gabriel Monastery is not the only monastery with court cases against it, which have done by ministries or public authorities of the Turkish state. The Syriac minority I just talked about doesn't have the same rights under the Treaty of Lausanne. It doesn't have the right to have the schools in its own language, Aramaic, which is somewhat peculiar because Aramaic was the language which was actually spoken by Jesus Christ himself.
You want state to offer official education for less than a few thousand people out of 73 million people? You have to be reasonable, friends. Thank you.
Let me remind you once again that Syrian minorities are not under provision of Lausanne Treaty. So that's why I think that we should oppose this amendment.
What is the opinion of the committee?
Committee, Mr. President, approved the amendment.
Thank you. I now put the amendment to a vote, and the vote is open. The vote is closed. I call for the result to be displayed. The amendment number 13 is agreed to.
Thank you.
The first item of the business this afternoon is debate on the report on the freedom of religion and other human rights for non-Muslim minorities in Turkey and for the Muslim minorities in Thrace, Eastern Greece, presented by Mr. Hino on behalf of the Committee on Legal Affairs and Human Rights.
Le 17 mars 2006, notre assemblée décidait de renvoyer à la Commission des questions juridiques et des droits de l'homme pour rapport les propositions de résolution relatives à la liberté de religion et autres droits de l'homme des minorités non musulmanes en Turquie et à la situation difficile de la minorité musulmane turque en Thrace occidentale Grèce.
Finally, can I specifically mention, and I'm very pleased the rapporteur mentioned this in his opening speech, the case of Mor Gabriel Monastery in Turkey. This is part of the Syriac Orthodox Church. It's clearly a very ancient, this is a very ancient church, one of the most ancient branches of Christianity, and this is a truly ancient monastery. It's a very complicated legal situation, as I think the report makes clear, but it would be good to hear that the monastery was kept in good order and there for future generations.
And the next speaker is Mr. Omzik on behalf of EPP.
We have an excellent report from the rapporteur on which I would like to congratulate him. And I'm a bit worried, colleagues, by what I hear from colleague Papadimoulos. Because it's your own citizens, as Mrs. Lundgren said. It's your own citizens you want to protect, independently of what another country is doing to its citizens. It should be the convictions of both of these governments of these countries that it's worthwhile of minorities that have been living there, some for 200 years and some for 1600 years, that they're just treated as equals. We shouldn't need international treaties for that. It's a pity we need them. It should be the conviction of people, of brothers to live together. And it's a bit of a shame that it's about two countries that once had large minorities. Once, the Christian minority in Turkey was somewhat larger. And once, there were quite a few more Muslims in Greece. They should have learned before that living together is at an advantage. It is a bit of a pity that one of the countries still sent imams, paid for by their own government, to countries like Germany and the Netherlands. I wonder what other countries would think if other states would send religious dignitaries paid for by the state into their own territory. So I think great steps have to be made. Having said that, great steps have been made. I've been traveling myself to southeastern Turkey, have seen the Mor Gabriel Monastery to which Mr. Klepperson, Mr. Papadimoupoulos and Mr. Hunor referred. Beautifully restored, just as the Zafaran Monastery. Beautiful examples of the heritage which is part of the cultural heritage of Turkey. Not of the rest of Europe, it's Turkish cultural heritage. Just like Greece has a lot of Muslim cultural heritage and should be proud of it. We should be proud of our own diversity. Yet, the minorities don't always have the same rights yet. That's why I propose a few amendments, because in, for example, Turkey, the Syriac community, to which the Mor Gabriel belongs, is not protected by the Lausanne Treaty and does not have the same rights. And there are a number of court cases against similar monasteries. So I would ask the Turkish